Well, very good morning to class 9th students. We are here with your new chapter poem, The Bengal Sellers. Please pay attention on your books, open your books, textbook as well as workbook. This poem is written by Sarojini Naidu, who was called the Nightingale of India by Mahatma Gandhi because of the color imagery and lyrical quality of her poetry. She had used her poem in Bengal Sellers, example is musical verse. The poem is a song of men who sell glass bangles at village fair in the temple town. The different colored bangles symbolize different stages of women's life as a young maiden, a bride, and a middle-aged matron. Matron, you can say married mother, and an elder woman. So, we can create the music of the poem as we read aloud. And we can look for different colors of the glass bangle and see how well they sit to the stage in women's life. Sarojini Naidu was an important presence in the freedom struggle and worked alongside with Gandhiji. Her birthday is celebrated as Women's Day to recognize the powerful voice of the women in Indian history. So you can well see, this is Sarojini Naidu, one of the renowned poet of India. Let me read about the poet more. So this Bengal Seller is one of her well-worked known poem. It included her collection of poems that is called The Bird of Time. The Bird of Time, you can underline. It focuses our attention on the social, religious, and symbolic values of bangles in Indian culture. No Indian widow is supposed to wear bangles. The wearing of bangle is suggestive of happiness, peace, and prosperity. The newlyweds wear bangles of different color. Hues means color. From those worn by unmarried girls. The first stanza of the poem describe in brief familiar setting of the poem. A group of bangle sellers is on the way of the temple fair to sell their bangles. The bangle sellers are poor, but they do not talk of their poverty. One of the bangle sellers tell us each stage in stanza. In each stanza we come to know about the Indian woman life in terms of longing for bangles for a particular color. Each stanza in fact deals with each of the three stages in an Indian woman's life. As a virgin girl, as an expectant bride, as a mature matriarch. So this is what idea we get from the poem. Now, let us see about the poem stanza wise. I'll be reading for you in a good manner. You can also read with me, all of you. Be ready? Put your finger in the books. Bengal sellers are we who bear our shining lots to the temple fair. Who will buy this delicate bride, rainbow tinted circles of light? Lustrous token of radiant lives for happy daughters and happy wives. I repeat, Bengal sellers are who we bear our shining lots to the temple fair. Who will buy this delicate bride, rainbow tinted circles of light? Lustrous token of radiant lives for happy daughters and happy wives. What do we mean by this stanza? In this stanza, the poet is speaking. The poet is telling that a group of bangle sellers are on their way to the temple fair so that they could make some money by selling bangles. Though they have carried the loads of bangles, they are not happy. That is why the loads of bangles to them are shining loads and mean for happy daughters and happy wives. This multicolor, different colors bangles are beautifully described as rainbow tinted circles of light. By repeating this word happy, the poet has emphasized the human element of product. The daughters who expect to be married soon wear bangles to express their happy longings. The wives who wear bangles express their happiness and contentment in their material life. So this is what we mean with first stanza. Let us see second stanza now. Some are meat for maiden's wrist, silver and blue as mountain mist. Some are flesh like birds that dream on the tranquil brow of woodland stream. Some are aglow with the bloom that cleaves to the limpid glory of newborn leaves. I repeat the stanza. Some are meat for the maiden wrist, silver and blue as mountain mist. Some are fresh like birds and dream of the tranquil brow of woodland stream. Some are aglow with the bloom that cleaves to the limpid glory of newborn leaves. What do we mean by this stanza? Pay attention, dear students. The second stanza describes the bangles of various colors. Some of the bangles are silver and blue, as misty as mountain mist. They are meant for the virgin girl, virgin unmarried girl, who has countless longing for her married life. Some are as pinks as birds that float on the calm surface of the forest stream. Some of these bangles are shining green, whose freshness is close to the vivid beauty of the newborn, tender leaves. All these kinds of bangles are suitable for unmarried girls. Their color express their tender longings. Longings means desires. So two stanza I have clear to you. Remaining three more stanza I'll take in a short while.